Hassan College, India. I'm going to present on role of Rukshana as a Purva Karma of Vrechana in management of Sthalya, which is obesity, pre-diabetic symptom. First of all, I want to thank you, Rao sir, to give me a chance to present here a presentation on Ayurveda. For understanding the best part, aspect of Ayurveda, I want to give first introduction of Ayurveda before starting my presentation. So Ayurveda is one of the world's oldest holistic health system, which was discovered in India. Ayurvedic medicine is a system of health of traditional Indian system, medicine system. Ayurveda is derived from Atharvaveda during the Vedic period. The god of Ayurveda is Lord Dhanvantri. The picture of Lord Dhanvantri is here. The principle of Ayurveda, the way of life, is Swasthasya Swastha Rakshanam Aturasya Vikara Prashanam. The quote, it means that the aim of Ayurveda is to maintain the health of healthy person, but as well as to treat the ailment of sick person. This is the main thing, the principle of Ayurveda, a way of life. Next, I'm coming to the origin of a body, or we can say composition of body. And many pathies agree with this quotation that our body is made of panch mahabhutas. It is akash, space, vayu, air, agni, fire, jala, water, prithvi, earth. Next slide is very important in Ayurveda. It is three dosha aspect. So in Ayurveda, we feel that our body is composition of panch mahabhut, three dosha, seven dhatus, and the three doshas are vata, pitta, and kapha. The vata role is main to all sensory part, all motor nervous system, all body movements, sleep, thinking process is due to vata. Otherwise, there is no vata will be there, it will be not possible. And the second thing is pitta, the all metabolic rate, all metabolism of agni, of digestion system, of eyesight, of anabolism, catabolism is due to pitta. Next is kapha. The all sanguine fluid in, present in our body, cerebral fluid, liquid part is due to kapha. This chart is showing that vata is ether and air, pitta is water and fire, kapha is due to earth and water. So next I am coming to the treatment, the chikitsa part of Ayurveda. We believe two types of treatment, one is shamana and another is shodhana. So it is difficult to understand for shamana because I translated in English also. Pacification of vitiated doshas. Doshas are nothing. They are the imbalance, impurities of our body. Shodhana, panchkarma, which I am taking a part today, that cleansing of a metabolic waste. I am going to discuss in further slides what is a shodhana and panchkarma. So you can say biopurification of body. So panchkarma. This is showing the introduction of panchkarma. Five treatment modalities, vamana, virechana, two types of basti, nasya, and what we do is purv karma, pre-operative, pradhan karma, operative, pashchat karma is post-operative procedure, the preventive, curative and rejuvenating. So all you saying, all must be thinking, why panchkarma, why I am talking about panchkarma, what is panchkarma? So this is your answer. Method of biopurification through natural orifice, unique treatment of modalities. Unique treatment of modalities means we can change our modalities according to person. It can vary one person to another person. We can change the treatment. We can do a special treatment for different body type, because in our system we think and we believe that one person body system is different from other body person. So unique treatment modalities are there. Real pathogenesis breaker, na punarbhava means long lasting effect. It will be not like that after having some days medicine of antibiotic course or something else, but it finishing the course. It is not that. It is the means to we are clearing the root cause of that disease. So today we are discussing three aspects: not preventive, curative, and promotive. We are not discussing only curative. This is the only from among five modalities. I am taking only one. Virechana is a therapeutic purgation for pitta, mainly downward expulsion of dosha through anal route by taking medicine. Diabetes, skin disease, digestive disorders, mouth ulcer, eye disease, headache, constipation, jaundice, etc. can be treated by this panchkarma. This modality of treatment is virechana. So this is a picture how the drugs during this process we administrate to the person, how they look like. Some of them are powder, some of them are liquid, some of them in tablet form. Now I'm coming to the diabetes and metabolic disorders. The prevalence of pre-diabetes, it is syndrome has skyrocketed, and it is 61% in last decade. From the country which I came is India. So Southeast countries like bearing most of burden of this disease. Clinical trial proved evidence of benefit only the people with pre-diabetes. All the people who develop this disease always go under phase of pre-diabetes. It can vary from length of the that period person to person. This is the picture which showing the part most of population who are suffering from this diabetes or this disease. So targeting people with pre-diabetes, lifestyle intervention should be aimed at people with the pre-diabetes. We talking since yesterday, life intervention should be there. So Madhumeh, it's diabetes mellitus. Madhumeh is a word from Ayurveda. So has been mentioned as one of the sequel of obesity. So before Madhumeh, it is obesity is there coming to the person. It is alarming effect. It is alarming time for the person to make sure that it should be changed. For obesity, one of the line of treatment is virechana, which I am talking and which I am taking today. In obese patient, there is a fear that snehapan may further increase disability. We are taking two groups of patient in research work we taken. One is a snehan and a rukshana. Rukshana is a purv karma prior to snehan, particularly in condition like obese patients. So objective of this study to assess the efficiency of virechana performed by using classical snehan purv karma in pre-diabetes. To evaluate the role of virechana performed by connecting rukshana drying therapy as a purv karma prior to snehan oilation therapy in pre-diabetes. To ascertain whether performance of rukshana prior to abhyantara snehapana in virechana provide better relief in pre-diabetes by comparing both of the groups. Material and methods. A source of data is taken 30 patients from OPD and IPD of SDM College Ayurveda Hassan are taken. Method of collection was that the 30 obese patients who were under with or without first degree relative suffering from type 2 diabetes mellitus were selected for the further detail investigation as per the following inclusion criteria. So this is the inclusion criteria and exclusion criteria by which we can explain the people who are been through this process by two different groups. Plan of study. The selected patient were into two, I already told you, a group S and group R. Internal oilation means snehapana and direct drying therapy means rukshana. So group S, the Snehapan group, this is a medicine. Murchita Ghrit was administered orally in the increasing dose till the Samyak Snigdh Lakshanas were observed. It means that Murchita Ghrit is a medicinal ghrita which is available in Ayurveda medicines. It is given to the person and it is observed what is going after effect. Swedhana, the Sarvanga Abhyanga with Murchita Tela and Mridu Bashpa Swedha was given in 3 gap of days. That some steam process will be there, for Swedhana is denoting the steam process. After this, we'll give patient is introducing to the Swedhana. So Virechan Karma with the Rechak Vati is the name of a drug which we introduce to the patient in dose of 2 tablets was performed by classical method. Tarpanadi Samsarjan Karma depending on the Shuddhi. It means, this line means that we will wait for the symptom which we are needed there for patient. It is not like I am giving a person for 5 days, it is not possible to, it can vary person to person, it can be 4 days, 5 days, 6 days or 7 days. So group R, Rukshana, what is the difference we given? The diet is rice and wheat chapati was replaced by chapati made by barley. The patient was advised to take buttermilk 2 times a day before meal. Drug. The patient was administered Trifla Kwatha, the name of drug, orally in 50 ml 3 times a day before meal. 7 days Udvartan is a dry powder massage with Trifla Adi Churan was done overall the body. All the above diet drugs were given simultaneously for 7 days till Samyak Rukshana Lakshanas was observed. The same that we will wait for the Lakshanas to appear and then we can understand whether we have to go further or whether we have to pursue the treatment which are we doing. So Snehapana Murchita Ghrit was administered orally in increasing dose till Samyak Snigdh Lakshan was observed. It is increasing dose, like today we giving 30 ml, tomorrow it's 60, then 90, then 120. It is not the same dose we follow for every day. Swedhana, Sarvang Abhyanga with Murchita Tela and Mridu Bashpa Swedha was given in 3 days. Virechan Karma with the Rechak Vadi and 2 tablets of carried out with the classical method. Samsarjan Karma, it is a post-operative measurements which we do is Samsarjan Kala. In technical language is Samsarjan Kala according to Ayurveda. So Tarpanadi Samsarjan Kala depending on the Shuddhi. The purification of that body is done or not. It is not like I already told you, it can vary person to person. We have to wait for 5 days, we have to wait for 6 days, might be 7 days, or it can be done in 4 days also. But the body language, the body type is different. One person is different from another person. So assessment criteria on basis of fasting blood sugar, BMI, OGTT, lipid profile. So coming to results, this is a significant results. This table showing you overall improvement with Snehe, the S group, Snehana Purva Karma Virechana. So you can see the significant result on BMI, OGTT, LDL, VLDL and triglycerides. But in next presentation, in R group, it is more beneficial for the patient. So by this we can say Rukshana is more significant therapy before going for a Snehapana. So we get more results in Rukshana group. So discussion, I'm coming to discussion. As Sthalya obesity is the Bahu Dosh Pradhan Vyadi, it is a multiple disease disorder. Biopurification is the first line of treatment which should be adopted for increased Kapha Pradhana Dosha which are brought to Kosht by Snehan and Swedan are expelled out by Virechana. Thus, Rukshan Purva Karma, Snehan and Virechana help in the expelling the doshas in larger quantity and reduce the sign and symptom of pre-diabetes, which is very necessary. Virechana medicines get absorbed due to virya, the potency. It reaches to the heart, hridaya, then to the dhamnis, blood vessels, and thereafter it reaches to the macro and micro channels of the body. Due to ushna guna, the compactness of dosha, disease occurring particle, is liquefied. Action of a tikshan guna is break the mala and dosha and their quick exertion. Due to the sukshma guna, endogenic toxic are excreted through the micro channels, mainly due to the prabhava, prithvi, jala, constitution and presence of saraguna, virechan occurs. This is the evacuate action. Rukshana has antagonistic nature to the medha and kapha, abheshchi and kapha. Thus, Rukshana Purvakam Virechan does added beneficial to the shodhana, biopurification. It means that by this only we can understand how it is more beneficial in Rukshana group than a Snehana group. So, by conclusion, Rukshana Purvaka Virechana, Snehana Purvaka Virechana provide better relief than respect to all subjective and objective parameters. Rukshana Purvaka Virechana has better role on providing relief to the patient of pre-diabetes sthalya. Rukshana Purvaka Virechana therapy proved very significant in weight management and reduction of glucose lipid profile. Ayurveda has very broad and synergetic view of understanding the pathophysiology of treatment principle for obesity and constitutes. By this, I would thank you to all. Go natural, live Ayurveda, go green. And it's an alarming time. We can do before we can control diabetes before it occurs. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. Very interesting. Do you have any questions or comments? Yes, please. Microphone.
Yeah, it is there. I told you that Virechana is a treatment which we do in different type of disease. It is not like we only diabetes is we controlling diabetes. We doing pitta management. Under pitta, many disease like eyesight, like metabolic system, like digestion, like weight loss, all come together.
How much was the weight loss?
It again varies person to person. It is depend on the type of body. It is vata, pitta, kapha, or part of two things. Vata pitta, pitta kapha, and minimum we recorded 3 kgs in a span of 7 to 10 days, and it can goes to 10 to 12 kgs. It can goes, and it already like it. It depend on the body type, and it depend on the precaution we taking care. Whether patient is going to a proper channel of treatment, whether he is not breaking rules which are told by the doctor, and this is the thing.
Well, in the scheme of things, I think you should do two different things. One is do a population-based study to show that people of cardiometabolic diseases cluster under pitta. It should, theoretically. And that has not been done. And the second thing that you had to do is these type of studies should be randomized studies and take a totally blind approach. to show whether or not this working and establish appropriate statistical data. Because Ayurveda has been used for thousands of years, yet we do not have clinical data to support any of our findings. We assume that it all came from God and so it's good. But in order for us to present in this type of situations and in good journals, you need a larger study, well planned. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your suggestion.
And okay, so thank you very much. Here is your certificate, please.
Thank you. I want to have a picture.